VAR, of course, came into play for the first time in the knockout stages this year, and it was called upon a couple of times. Said the first one, the Diego Costa penalty that the referee initially gave. Clearly, looking at the replay, it was outside of the box. The second one, not as clear cut. The boys in the studio, we all watched it together, thought that the referee got it spot on. In the end, there was a push from Morata, despite the fact he got the goal. Do you agree?
Yes, I do. I think one of the things it's worth adding, though, at this stage is, as you've just said, looking at the replay, the decisions were right. Of course, there's 68,000 people in this stadium who aren't looking at a replay. And so they're kind of baffled by this. And Morata, obviously, he knows that he's pushed the defender in the back. But there is this moment where he celebrates. The stadium even booms out the post-goal music, which maybe it shouldn't do. I think we probably, most of us would agree, we don't particularly like that. But it did feel like a kind of a real emotional letdown. I think one of the many impressive things about Atletico Madrid tonight was, this is a club that has been given to fatalism over the years. And when you've had two breakthroughs and you really do think you've broken through, taken away from you by VAR, one that you think you've got a penalty, the other that you think you've got the goal, it was very possible, I think, at that stage for Atletico Madrid to crumple. But instead they did the opposite at a time when I think a lot of people in this stadium who hadn't seen those VAR decisions were kind of feeling like the opportunity had slipped away. Diego Simeone felt the opposite, and he sent that team even more aggressively into attack. And in that sense, I think they were very, very impressive indeed. And even the VAR couldn't damage them in the end.
A fine finish from Raheem Sterling means that Manchester City take a 3-2 lead going into that second leg. I will start, if you don't mind, boys, by talking about the penalty, because that seems to be what everyone is talking about. VAR was used. The referee initially gave a corner, looked at it. Well, VAR looked at it and said penalty. This is where the ball struck Otamendi on the arm. The ref get it right?
Well, both refs, because the reason he told the VAR told the referee to go and view it is because he thought it was a penalty as well. So
he was unable to view it because we had technical difficulties.
All right, with the monitor. That's right. Sorry.
That's all right.
It didn't take very long to sort it out. No idea, because the players were all surrounded, and he was like, chaos. It was a bit school headmaster kind of, but obviously there was some technical issues. The ball was hustling towards the goal from a distance away. The distance between the player striking it and Otamendi was enough that with the ball going on the target and Ederson making a save, it hits his arm. He could get it out of the way.
He tried to get out of the way, though, didn't he?
Well, he didn't get it out of the way quick enough. And you can, in a split second, you can move your arm. The problem here, and I'll keep repeating this, is the ways the laws are written.
Right.
And I've heard referees talking about it on radio shows and stuff, how his mates at IFAB or whatever it is, God knows what you do when you go there.
Well,
that's another story. But they've got to get this written properly because it's so subjective. Because they keep using the thing, well, there was no intent. But most penalties you see given, there was never any intent.
Yeah.
But
so what do you do, give a lie detector test? You know, it's kind of impossible to decide.
No, but it's true, though, isn't it? Once you put that sort of wording
in. For God's sake, Mr. Hislop.
The wording will change to appease everybody here at the very least. But I think, given the distance the ball travels, Otamendi can get his arm out of the way. And whether the question then becomes whether it's his responsibility to move his hand away from the ball. Once your arm is extended away from your body, even slightly as it was, yes, the onus is on you to get it out of the way if it's heading towards your hand. And I think, despite how well it was struck, he had enough time to pull his hand away. He didn't. As a result, I think the referee got it right.
100% a penalty. And whoever takes a look at this video and says otherwise, they are kidding themselves. There is clearly a distance between Cagliari and Otamendi. Enough distance for him to react. And oh, by the way, if he doesn't hit his arm, who's to say that that ball doesn't go in the back of the net? So are we trying to project what may happen, what could happen, what the intent was, what the intent wasn't? The truth of the matter is that it impacted the play in a way in which you have to call a penalty once you see that replay.
But I tell you what, it was gritty from City because it wasn't.
Yeah.
It wasn't perfect by...
Let's not forget, they were 10 men down.
Do you know something? I actually thought they were better with 10 men because Company comes on, they forfeit David Silva. Company comes on and brings a bit of calmness to the whole thing because it was one of those evenings, by the way, where you got Schalke sitting, I think, 14th in the Bundesliga.
Right.
So although they're in the Champions League, they're not having a great season. They're not a great side this year, not playing well. And we talked on yesterday's show, I thought complacency was the only thing, or stupid basic errors.
Right.
Now, you might, I don't know if you can call the Otamendi handball an error, but certainly the Fernandinho and then the Otamendi sending off, which is crazy. Mm-hmm. That was silly, complacent, you know, basic stuff, which is going to cost you against an inferior team. He went to your back three with Stones, with Walker, Otamendi, who hasn't played much, and Laporte. And it wasn't great. Then he went to your back four in the second half. He dropped Fernandinho back in there. So he made some changes. And they gritted it out. Obviously, there was a great goal from Sané. And then Sterling gets the winner. And listen, we talk about Sterling a lot. It wasn't his greatest game. But every facet of this guy's game at the moment has just got better and better and better.
Good finish, yeah?
Particularly in the final third. And that's just the difference. He's a world-class footballer. And he's got better, so much better, over the last 24 months.
This was a really good second-half performance from Atleti, and one thoroughly deserving of the win.
Absolutely, and this, one of the surprising things, apart from the open play, was how, at times, Juventus struggled with the set pieces. You know, you look at the size of their team. You know, Ronaldo's great in there, Mandzukic is great in there. You know, the two centre-halves, then you get likes of Emre Can. The big side, big physical side. But we know Atleti are a physical side as well, but they really struggled from that department. And actually, they looked rattled as the game was going on, and I think that was the key. They looked flustered and started. I mean, the game was full of complaining about the referee from both sides.
Yep.
But it just got worse as Atleti piled the pressure on. And look, they absolutely deserve this. And now they go back to Turin and they have to break down one of the toughest, meanest, ugliest defensive sides when they want to be in world football. That's going to be tough.
They weren't quite that side, though, tonight, were they?
No. No, they were not. And yesterday we were critical of Liverpool and their lack of energy in moments where they could have pressed Bayern Munich. Well, what you saw today from Atletico Madrid is that when there was an opportunity for Juventus to try to slow down the game, which is what Juventus wanted to do, Atletico Madrid did not allow Juventus to do that. They got on them. They pressed them in the midfield. They created turnovers. We saw the chances from Diego Costa. It comes from a turnover out of the midfield and a pass by Antoine Griezmann, and it happened time and time again in that second half. That energy then from the players on the field also created quite the atmosphere at the Wanda Metropolitano. Yeah. The place was jumping. The place was electric, and that rattle, that frustration that you're talking about, I think it has to do with the fact that Atletico Madrid never allowed Juventus to think in the second half. They got on top of them, should have scored a couple goals, did not, but in the end, set pieces, they count all the same. 2-0 and well-deserved by Atletico Madrid.
Welcome into Extra Time. It's quite a special Extra Time. Mm. The final one is Schalke as a 40-year-old because Friday, is it Schalke turned 50?
In the 40s, yes.
In the 40s.
Mid-40s-ish.
Not anymore.
You're going to be 50 on Friday.
Not anymore.
I'm still mid-40s-ish.
Well, right now.
And what are you doing to celebrate, Shaq?
I'm going to North Carolina to see my daughter.
Uh-huh.
See, three of my daughters, two are there visiting their big sister, and I'm going to go down like the responsible father that I am.
Are you making any stops on the way down?
I may stop for refueling. something to eat. And something to drink?
Yep.
We'll have a lovely time.
Yes.
I'll try.
Who's the old man over there?
You're the oldest one on the panel.
Well, until barely alive Clive and nearly dead Fred. Barely alive Clive and nearly dead Fred. They're not on today. They'll be back tomorrow.
They both. No, Maris is in England, isn't it? Stevie's back tomorrow. Anyway, what other predictions does Ali have for the world? He called Jimenez and Godin goals as the only reason Atleti would win today. Did you?
Yes, I did.
On the show?
Yes, were you not here? Mm-hmm. It was cutting edge analysis.
Was it? Must have switched off at that stage.
That Xhaka will not be here for work.
Yes.
I'm going to go with that one, and I think I'm going to be correct. Even if I didn't know he was leaving, I know that it's a shot in the dark.
Who's going to do your power rankings?
Yeah.
What?
Because we know the pride you take. I mean,
yeah, who does the power rankings?
Pride you take in that. Maros.
I may do them all the same.
Stevie could do it.
I'm not going to shake my responsibilities.
Get Stevie up.
Get Stevie and Maros to do it.
Get Stevie and Paul at touchscreen. What could possibly go wrong?
After this performance today, is Atleti one of the favourites? They've been overlooked, but what a performance today.
Yeah, what a performance, but. No, their league form at times, even though they're still up there, has not. And he was asked today, Simeone, after the game, how can you play like that, but then you're losing the Liga the way you did? And so I think that was a great night for them, but I don't think they're favourites now.
No, they are not favourites.
If Juve fail to get past Atleti, is the season a failure and will Allegri get sacked?
It's a failure. Allegri won't get sacked.
You in a rush, Shaq?
Come on.
Wow.
What's the next question?
You really want to turn 50.
Check this. I'll check the snow for you, Jack. I'll check the snow.
Be all right.
I'm driving a plough.
Light snow.
Light snow.
I've got my plough with me.
Drive,
yes.
Anyway.
And where are you driving, Shaq?
North Carolina, eventually.
I don't think... Somebody's asking, where's he stopping off? Lots of places. Don't know the answer.
You know something I don't know, Craig?
He's going to take the scenic route.
You can't just keep winning. Well, you can, but I mean...
Oh, you're going back to the question.
Very Stevie Nicol of you.
But I'm not going to be like Steve. I'm going to say, well, don't ask me that.
Well, that's aggressive.
I hope someone's just switched on.
I've just cut it at that point. That's how it comes in.
I'm happy with that.
Oh, I'm never watching that ESPN FC again. They don't take it serious. Fools. There's never any analysis on there. Worst ever. Then tweet the next day. You said this. I thought you weren't watching. I'm not watching ever again. Till tomorrow.
Oh, man.
Give me boring enough. Give me boring shows. Scripted boring.
Give me
I can do scripted boring. I'll give it. I can do it. I can read off a prompter. If somebody starts putting stuff down that prompter, I'll read off it.
Is that the prompter?
I'll keep myself very politically correct. There you go. That's what you want.
Everything
I can do that.
Everything in VAR review looks like movie clips. Why doesn't VAR show a normal speed clip in a slow-mo one? It'll give so much more perspective to the decision maker.
Yeah,
What? What is it? Just saying the slow-mo maybe makes things look worse.
Oh. Yes. I once had a discussion with, when I was broadcasting games live in the UK from the stadium, with the director that I used to work
proper,
with.
Proper punditry.
Mm-hmm.
No.
He's been doing it for years.
Discussing.
No, because we worked together for a while, and there was a few incidents happened in a previous games where there was a little bit of shirt pulling, which looked horrendous on the slow-mo,
right.
But in real time, it was nothing. Okay. And I asked him if he could roll in less slow-mos. And in true director fashion, he ignored me.
Oh, that's not just directors, by the way. That's not just directors.
That's every day.
That's how I live my life on a daily basis.
Well, that's my play.
You should be a director.
I thought it was a valid point. I did ask him.
Oh, Mrs. Bird.
And he was a friend of mine. I said, look, you help me out here, less slow-mo. So that is a good point, but...
I think referees know that. Referees understand that things look different in slow motion and deal with it accordingly.
I was going to go somewhere. No, I didn't.
Don't.
Finally, how's your beard coming on?
Oh, great. Fading away.
Great.
Fading.
Still nothing on the
side. No, I'm going for the lower beard look.
No, you can't grow anything there.
No. That's just growth. That's random growth at this point.
You're not only the worst pundits in history.
Look at the haircut.
That's a haircut.
So I had a haircut.
We can give it to worst pundits in history, worst beards in history. Everyone. That is the worst beard.
No,
that's horrendous.
Seriously,
that's saying to me, get to Washington, D.C. now.
This beard's gotten good reviews.
Oh, there may be a stop here and there.
North Carolina.
North Carolina.
Oh, he's not going to D.C.
I'm going to visit my daughter.
All right, you keep saying that. Happy birthday. Have a lovely time.
Yeah.
When 50th.
Are you coming back?
50th.
At some point, I'm sure.
There it is.
To that.
Possibly.
None of us are here tomorrow apart from Ali.
Yay! True profession.
To talk Europa League.
True profession.
I'm going to North Carolina, I am.
All right, Shay, you keep saying that.
Sure you're going to North Carolina?
Yes, okay. I am.
Why did Craig say DC?
I don't know.
Or New York, for that matter.
I don't know. I don't know what's going on.